And they are here. Hi. Hi.
Hello. What's happening?
Hello.
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 We're doing that little satellite delay thing here, but that's okay.
You know, that's okay. It's fine.
Guys, we've been trying to put this together for a couple days. We really appreciate you guys working with us. What we did here in Pittsburgh is for the past 2 days, we allowed women to call the radio station and to give us their favorite Journey music memory. Something one of your songs always brings to top of mind when they think about it. And yeah, we had some pretty hot and heavy things to come through.
And, I brought my proof.
Yeah, she brought her husband. So that's
you brought
much...
your husband.
He reminds me of you. And you remind me of him. And so that's...
How
would
does
always,
he feel about that?
I don't know. He always buys me Journey CDs, so...
No Journey underwear yet?
No, I'm so, you don't have any out there yet.
Work, it's coming.
No.
It's coming.
Thank you.
It's the Variety 96 Journey interview, and we've given three ladies, we've told them to all pick out three questions apiece because we realize you guys
three
are
pairs of panties.
That's right, three pairs. And, you know, they got three shots at it, three strikes, and then you're either out or you got a home run. And I think we're going to start with, we're going to start with Joelle, first of all. Yeah. Joelle, you got three questions. You got the guys on the line. It's your radio show. Go for it.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
Hey. I'm a big fan of you, of all of you. My first question is, okay, you guys are on tour right now. Is Pittsburgh on your list of tours?
Well, we're not really on tour right now. We're talking about doing that in the summertime. So we're doing radio, and our video is actually out right now. It just came out last week on VH1, When You Love a Woman.
All right.
Yay!
In answer to your question, we definitely will try to get to Pittsburgh. Yes.
Yes, yes.
Well, will you just sing to me, and can I have tickets to see you, please?
Is that the second question?
No, that's not.
And will Neal come over and cook you dinner?
Well, I was going to invite you all over to my house for dinner. I'm not insane. I'm just asking you if you would come over. I'm not a stalker. I'm serious.
We don't know. We're working on that part.
You can ask my husband if you like.
It's getting nasty already.
I'm sorry.
But I'm digging it. You know,
it's getting good. These guys.
Question number two.
Well, everybody else is getting on the bandwagon. Would you guys ever consider doing a Christmas CD? I have room for, you know, more Journey CDs.
Well, we got a new one out called Trial by Fire.
I know. I got it. It was my birthday gift.
CD for this year.
Oh, yeah. That's it? That was my birthday gift, by the way, guys.
CD for this year.
Oh, well, it was my birthday gift. Thank you.
Have you guys ever thought about that?
Please think about it.
We like that. We do a lot of things live. That might be something we do live, but I don't know if we'll ever release it. We do a lot of things live.
Right. Oh, cool.
Well, and my, what is your favorite Journey song? Your personal favorites?
Who are you talking to?
Steve, Harry, first.
Oh. Let's see, my first impression would be Center My Love, I think, at this point, because I just like the way it has this name.
You just hit the nail on the head.
What about Love and Touch and Squeeze, and do you like that one?
Oh, I do like that one.
I love that one.
I like them all.
Okay. You know, well, so do I. That's why I have all your CDs.
I got to tell you guys, that is one of my favorite songs, being a radio guy, to play on the air, because every time I've ever got a chance to play that, it just makes me want to growl, go, loving, touching, and squeezing each other.
Okay, I love that.
Calm down now.
Oh, God.
I'm very moist.
Oh, God. Hey, thank you for sharing that.
Okay, we got Vicky coming up next. Guys, say hi to Vicky.
Hi, Vicky.
Hi, Vicky.
Hey, Vicky. Hello. How are you?
Hi.
Vicky, who do you want to talk
with
first?
Oh, who do I want to talk to first? I don't know.
Neal and John are here.
Hi, Neal and John.
Yeah, Neal and Jonathan Cain are there.
Jonathan Cain and Steve Perry are two of my personal favorite members of the group, although I love everyone. What's the song?
There's a lot of love in this room today. I want you to know that, and I'm feeling every bit of it.
I know that Jonathan Cain wrote the song Faithfully, which is my second favorite song by Journey.
Oh, thank you.
Life is my first favorite. Was When You Love a Woman inspired by someone in someone's life in the band, or how was this song written?
Steve had the title, and he came over with it, and it was just a lovely thing. And you know, we sat down. He had a little recorder that he was singing into, and I had a piano piece. Neal had a bridge, and we put it all together. And, you know, we were lucky. We got lucky that day. And it was a beautiful song.
Absolutely.
It is a very beautiful song.
You should see them. They're just, they're still shaking in here.
I can't believe we have them on the phone. Oh, my God. Oh, I wish I had pictures. Oh!
My wife saw a Raised on Radio concert 3 times, and I didn't pay for a single one. People kept taking me because they knew that that was supposedly going to be the last concert ever.
So that's where that ticket money went.
All mine. Oh. I was there at every...
So you went with... Did you go with 3 different guys?
No, my sister took me in Cleveland for my birthday, and then I went with some friends from school in Pittsburgh. And then we drove to West Virginia, the same kids from school.
Mm-hmm. God, he got lucky.
Wow.
And I got free tickets to all of them because I'm the only one with the car.
Payback.
I love that.
Next question.
Oh. A lot of bands have tried to imitate Journey's sound and style over the years. Have you guys been surprised by the success that your band had and the impact on the music industry? Or?
She sounds like she works in radio. Boy, good question, yeah.
She did her homework.
Who do you think has tried to imitate our sound?
A lot of people. I think a lot of people have, but I don't think anybody's ever succeeded.
White Snake.
Like who, for instance?
You think White Snake?
White Snake. Here I go again. Sounds a lot like a Journey song.
Yeah.
Well, it's a little white bread, though.
They're not as good as you guys.
Well said. Well put. Okay.
Sorry.
Okay.
Well, they always say that, you know, imitation is the best form of flattery. So,
yeah, that's true.
You know,
mm-hmm.
It's kind of flattering when, like, Prince. I mean, he called up. He took the chords from Faithfully and put him in Purple Rain. And didn't realize it until, you know, he heard our song, and then his manager called up and said, "Geez, Prince is awfully sorry, but..."
And he'll pay you, so don't worry about
it. Listen to this. The last chords of Purple Rain, mm-hmm. which is the end of Faithfully.
Uh-huh.
Just so you know.
Wow. You guys do it better.
Everybody has to sing.
Purple Rain.
They're still breathing heavy in here because of you guys.
Okay.
So
yeah. But he asked us, yeah.
That was very nice of him to call.
He called and said, "Forgive me, I made a mistake."
And we said, "Good luck. Have a hit."
That's nice guys.
It was good for us, should be great for you.
Okay, third and final question. Even though you guys are all back together, I have all of the stuff that you guys have done separately and solo from the band. Are you still work pursuing solo interest, or are you just back in Journey now?
Kind of put everything on hold for a while, you know? It's kind of all on hold, and we're working on Journey.
Yeah.
So
it took me a long time to get back in Journey, for crying out loud. What do I want
to
do that
for? We're love to have you back. We're so glad Journey's back.
Yeah. Are we happy?
I'm very happy.
I've been listening to Journey for 20 years. I'm glad Journey's back.
Oh, make them feel old. I'm sure they appreciate the heck out of that.
I started
That's
listening
okay.
We were two.
The next album is the first one that I've ever, that I have, the first album I ever bought of Journey's was Next. And I have everything.
They're diehards over here.
All right.
We got everything.
Well, guys, we're going to segue over to...
Send them a poster, for God's sake.
Oh, yeah.
Send us an autograph, would you?
No, they want the underwear. You brought it up.
We'll autograph our underwear.
We want tickets.
We have Journey Crotsless panties.
Will you sign them? Do you want us to send you our underwear? We'll sign them if you'd like.
We're not going to go there.
We'll send you ours.
We're not going to go there. We're not going to go there.
Okay, never mind.
Trying to make a deal here.
I feel like I got a movie clicker over here. We're not going
to
go there.
We're just trying to talk to him.
We're trying to
make a deal.
You're interrupted.
Man, I'm glad I wore sweatpants today. Okay, we got Peggy Perino over here. Peggy's got some questions for you guys. Our final contestant today on the Want to Be a DJ show. Good.
Yeah. Right.
Peggy, lay them out.
Okay, hi. How are you?
We can barely hear you.
Oh, okay. Great.
Let's make it a little
bit louder.
Sure,
just put me number 3 and then you can hear me.
How about that? Is that better?
Can you hear me now?
A little bit. Go ahead, yeah.
Okay, my first question is for Steve. If you were ever to record a duet with another female vocalist, who would you want it to be and why? Like
God,
anybody from Unknown in Pittsburgh when you come.
Like us.
Like me. in all seriousness, though. Pardon me?
What'd she say at the last part?
If she was an unknown singer, like myself, from Pittsburgh.
Are you a singer?
Yes.
Are you a singer?
Yeah, from Pittsburgh.
You are?
Yes.
Send them a demo.
Are you like... She's Italiano.
Yes, that's right.
She's a singer nice.
I make my own. I make my own sauce, too.
What kind of songs do you sing?
I do
a
variety.
What kind of songs are you singing now?
Right now, I do pretty much of a variety of pop and, you know, rock. And
can you sing us something?
Sure.
Sing us something, yeah.
What would you like to hear?
What do you want to do? We don't know your repertoire.
This is great. It's live. Well,
I'd love to sing like Send Her My Love because that was a dedication, but what did you say?
Come on, girl.
She's going to talk to her manager first.
You
right?
Just okay. Go, girl. Sing
all right.
For him.
It's been such a long time. I think I should be going, yeah. The time doesn't wait for me. It keeps on rolling.
Wow.
Hey.
She's got some lungs on her, and I'm not looking at her clothes.
I was going to say. She's got lungs, and she sings nice, too.
Yeah. Oh, God.
Sign her up. Right there. Sign her up. Quick. Give her the bonus plan. Come on, everybody.
No, that's a beautiful tone.
Oh,
that's a
thanks.
Nice tone. Very nice timbre.
She's all blush now. She's got this. She goes, I don't even want to go to the next question. I want to stay where I'm at.
Yeah. Okay.
I don't think I've never heard a cappella Boston before. That's cool.
Well, you got it live. Yeah. What can I say?
Don't worry. They'll do an unplugged tour next. So watch out.
Yeah, well, you know what? In all seriousness, I mean, do you have an answer for me? I mean, I would like to know who do you admire as a female vocalist?
There's so many great singers. You know, I love Gladys Knight. She's one of my favorite singers of all time.
Oh, yeah.
Sade.
And I think for some reason the industry right now is, you know, has a tendency to turn its back on certain artists. And she happens to be one right this moment. That I love Roberta Flack. And thank God that the Fugees recorded that song because now Roberta Flack has credibility.
Right, mm-hmm. Exactly.
And let's face it, they just took her song and put a hip-hop to it. So I love her voice. I mean, that would be fun.
Oh, that's great.
That's an interesting combination. I'd like to hear that myself.
Yeah, I'd like
myself.
To hear that, too.
Yeah,
she's great.
Okay. Wow. Let me see. I have a question, just whoever wants to answer it. When you're on the road,
Neil.
You know... Neil?
Neil, you're on.
Neil, do you
wake
jump?
Up.
Come on.
Can you speak up a little bit? I'm having a hard time hearing.
Wait, he can't hear me.
It's been a lot of years of rock and roll and loud amplifiers. You got to speak up, baby.
Okay. Well, when you're on tour, I mean, what effect does it have on your personal life? When you're away for so long, you know, being on the road, away from family, what effect does it have on you personally?
Well, you know what? You end up missing them a lot more, you know, especially I've got 3 children now. So, you know, you miss them, but we're going to work it out so that they come out some of the times when we're hanging in one city for longer period than a couple days. And, you know, we'll get through it.
Oh, that's great.
Okay. Lots of groups are taking their kids on the roads nowadays.
That's right.
A lot of groups are.
Yeah, they love it. I mean, my kids just love to see me play live. You know, it's really a kick to watch them watch.
That's cool. That's really cool.
Good. Okay, my last question is for Steve Perry. Was the grief from the loss of your mother a motivating factor in your career? Can you hear me?
You know, she passed just about in the middle of the making of the Raised on Radio record when she passed. So she was always supportive, though, from the very beginning when I was really young.
Uh-huh.
You know, I turned to her when I was very young and said, Mommy, I want to be a movie star. I couldn't say that, you know. And so she supported me through that because my dad was a singer. And her father, who was kind of the controlling force of the family, said, What the hell are you talking about? Goddamn kids, you know. But he wanted me to be a farmer, but I just couldn't hang the idea of milking cows. So.
Well, we're glad you're not a farmer.
He'd rather pluck guitar better. Strings and pluck udders. Yeah. I can take that, you know.
Yeah.
And wait, like Steve, we did.
Strings, girl.
Steve, we did hear that you have the most beautiful hair, so we'd like to see that sometime.
We'd like to get you down here.
Be careful. Girl, I saw that look on her face. She is a stalker.
Oh,
she is a stalker.
No.
They're doing a personal check on her as we speak.
Yes,
we think. Guys, what I hope is that it's a summer show, so it'll be outdoors and nice and hot, and you can sit on your boyfriend's shoulders and show us your...
smiles.
Go there! Yep.
Your bristles!
This show has been rated for the hearing impaired. Okay.
show us your bristles.
Oh, God. Behave.
Hey, Steve. Neil and Jonathan, we really appreciate you guys taking a few minutes with us. It's been great, and we know the tour is coming up. We're going to keep our ears open for the tour dates, and of course, we're going to go out right now with, of course, your number one song, When You Love a Woman. And
Can I tell you real quick?
Yeah, sure, go ahead.
Can I tell you something?
Sure, talk.
Just one big favor, since you got so many fans there in the studio and people who listen to your station, When You Love a Woman is our song, and we just finished a video for it, and VH1 is playing it, and we're real proud of it. But for some reason, MTV doesn't want to play it at this present moment. So I'm going to give you a phone number, 1-800-DIAL-MTV. That's 1-800-342-5688.
Mm-hmm.
And after 5 o'clock New York time, have people in the, and these people and your friends, everybody in the studio, call them and say, hey, why don't you play that new Journey video, When You Love a Woman?
We'll do that.
Because done
I
deal.
Guess we don't wear, you know, it'd be great.
Done deal.
It was great talking to you guys.
Yeah, thanks for
it. Was an honor.
Merry Christmas. Happy holidays.
You too.
Same to you.
Well, you
happy guys,
holidays.
We'll let you guys
Same
take you. It out. We got about 15 more seconds. Anything else you want to say to Pittsburgh?
Have yourself a merry little Christmas.
No, same to you.
That's great.
Steve
that
Perry
great.
And Journey, Variety 96.
In my life, I'll see where I've been. I said that I'd never fall again. Within myself, I was wrong. My searching ain't over.